Hello, this is Dr. Gay from First Look MRI, and this is a 66-year-old female with shoulder pain, and this is an example of a large subacromial subdeltoid bursal effusion with multiple nodular synovial inflammatory changes without. It's a really great example of rice bodies. So this is a classic for rheumatoid arthritis. You see these little things here, these nodular little specks all throughout this significantly distended bursa, and this is a synovial inflammatory process, but most likely rheumatoid arthritis. And you can see they look just like little rice particles here. And over here along the medial side, this is the AC joint. There's a fluid in the AC joint. That's why it looks so funny here. And below that, this is part of the bursa. There's this glob of darkness here. And this is a synovial pseudomass. So it's more of a more prominent localized region of synovitis within the distended bursa. You can see the outline of the bursa here. This does push down on the supraspinatus tendon here. And so that's the main thing here, just a big bursal effusion with the rice body is a good example. Patient had a lot of other things I can run through really quickly, and that is they had a partial thickness tear, probably a full thickness tear, high-grade partial thickness tear. The supraspinatus, you can see that going down here, this little end where it comes over here along the bottom, that's the undersurface fibers that should detach way over here. They're torn and retracted way back here. The bursal surface fibers along the top come over. It looks like there is a small full thickness perforation. Couldn't really see that very well in other images. And they also had a prominent AC effusion here with some synovitis within it. So this goes along with the rheumatoid arthritis. If we come down here, they had a couple other interesting things. Number one, there's a tubular fluid collection within the infraspinatus. This is what we call an interstitial tear. The fluid from the attachment usually tracks backwards between the longitudinal fibers and the muscle here to the musculotendinous junction. This is a kind of one of the larger interstitial tears I've seen right here. And if we go down, the tear is minor, is in this region. I wouldn't say anything about that on this view, but if we put up a coronal view, we can see that the tear is minor. If we go to the back, here's the infraspinatus. It ends here, is all infraspinatus. The teres minor is down here. See how bright that is? This is a T1 weighted sequence, so the teres minor is severely atrophic, fatty atrophy. This may be related to an old neurologic insult. We see this pretty frequently, and they call that quadrilateral space syndrome. But in this patient, it's probably just incidental. And we're not done yet. A couple other things. On this view here, we see this large subacromial subdeltoid bursal effusion with those rice bodies. And also we see the biceps tendon. Here's the biceps tendon. Now the biceps tendon is, the sheath is filled with complex fluid, and we can see it here, not in the groove. Here's the bicipital groove, little cup it should be in, but instead it's over here, superficial to the subscapularis. So the biceps tendon is medially dislocated, and it's not deep to the subscapularis. So there's something here called the transverse ligament. It comes off the subscapularis, goes over the top, holds the biceps tendon in place. So the transverse ligament must be torn because the biceps tendon has dislocated immediately. So in this, I'll say the superior fibers of the subscapularis tendon and the transverse ligament component of the subscapularis are torn, allowing for medial dislocation of the biceps tendon. And the biceps tendon luckily is not ruptured. One more view of this big bursal effusion there, prominent bursitis, thin rotator cuff, and that teres minor that has a lot of fatty atrophy. You can see how this is extremely difficult or impossible to appreciate on any sequence other than that, the coronal images there. So this is fatty atrophy, but the fat and muscle are about the same. You can see subcutaneous fat and muscle so close, so you can't really tell that this is so atrophied and so fatty replaced, interestingly. And this is that interstitial tear within the infraspinatus. See that round fluid collection tracking between the longitudinal fibers. And that's it. Just a complicated case with lots of stuff wrong. But the main thing is just to see a good example of rice bodies. And that's it. Thank you very much.